So I was staying with them on the front line in Salah Hadin, just shooting a feature story about their daily life on the front line there. So I'd been with them a few days at that stage.
And they were in the street doing what exactly? What does this picture show that we're looking at right now?
Well, the first one, they were actually just cleaning up. There'd been a tank attack earlier, but it hadn't actually injured anyone. It hadn't been a direct hit, but it had just put some of the debris across the street. So they're just cleaning up the street.
And what was the atmosphere like at that point?
One of the most relaxed kind of moments that there had been. They were joking around. Issa, who has the hose in the front of that first photo, was, you know, like spraying water on them, joking, and it was very relaxed kind of scene. So when the call came in that there was a tank approaching, they weren't. That was probably the least prepared I've actually seen them. But even so, it took them a second to grab their weapons and be ready. But that second, the tank had already hit.
So talk us through the image where we see the blast initially and what you were going through that time as well.
When I heard them saying the tank was coming, I immediately sort of got set up, because that corner is where the action usually happens if there's a tank approaching. Within seconds, the blast came, smoke started covering the area. It went back quite a long way down the street too. And from where I was standing, which was just a couple of metres back from them, the debris started coming down also with the smoke cloud. So I had to run back myself. And the man who was injured in the foreground, he ran back also. So we just kind of came back and stood behind that cloud of smoke waiting for the other guys to come through. But no one came, and it took a few good minutes for the smoke to clear before we could see what had actually happened.
And what had happened? What had been the impact of that strike?
All three of them had been killed. We couldn't see immediately. We could see that they were all down on the ground. And so we had to like gradually approach. Also, we didn't know if the tank was coming back or still there, or any of the opposite to the government soldiers were coming down. So we had to be quite cautious in approaching the scene. But when we did get down there, it was horrible.
What do you think about your safety when you're doing this? And you must count yourself, you know, incredibly lucky for surviving that.
Yeah, when there is action, when there is something happening, usually what I'm thinking about is just trying to be in the right place, as safe as possible, but being able to capture what's going on.
And what about the victims and the families of those involved? You had an update about that.
One of the men had three children. He's the younger one. It was his younger brother as well. So I'm sure their entire family is quite devastated by that. And the older man there had one child, just a newborn child. I haven't managed to contact them, but what I really like to do when I go back to Aleppo is get in touch with the Katiba and see if I can contact their families. I know they were from the city of Mara, which is quite nearby Aleppo and a place I've spent a bit of time myself as well. So I'd like to go there and see if I can speak to the families and see how they're coping.